Hello and welcome everyone. So in this video, we'll talk about object-relational mapping, how Sequelize is doing it, and first of all, how to define this kind of schema model, and how that schema model is being mapped to the database for triggering the queries to get the data, update the data, insert all the data. So kind of a CRUD operation, how we are able to perform using JavaScript only, because Sequelize is giving us JavaScript wrapper so that we don't need to write SQL queries. So for that, let's first talk about Sequelize. It's a promise based object relational mapper. So it is just giving us the objects, and whenever we execute some methods, those all are returning the promises. So what is a promise? Promise is some kind of things. Promise represent eventual completion or a failure of asynchronous operation. I mean, in JavaScript world, we have a callback, promises, async await. So Sequelize is a Bluebird based promise methods. I mean, it provides all these kind of utility methods which are promise based. So whenever you try to execute any method, something like this, user.findById. So what user is representing here? User is representing some kind of a schema model, and it might be having some fields, okay, username, password, email ID, address and all. And whenever you do find by ID, indirectly what you are going to execute, you are executing select star from user where ID equal to 1. This is the SQL query which indirectly it is executing on MySQL, and it is going to give you that user JSON object. Okay, coming to the joins and all, because now we are not even writing SQL queries. We will manage everything from these schema models. When I say schema models, means the user, address, posts, or any kind of schema model which can represent independent MySQL table. So here I have one post object which is having user information also. So right. So indirectly, what is this? In language of SQL, it is just a join between the post table and the user table, and I'm returning a post information with user object. Means I'm doing a join with the user table and the post table and getting the individual post information, right? So all these kind of relationship, what it is, the relationship is one-to-one, one-to-many, or many-to-many, is being managed by Sequelize, right? So what we will do, we'll create a one schema model as a user, another schema model as a post, and then we will put user ID as a foreign key in the post table, so that from the user ID reference I can get the post information of those users, right? So Sequelize is a promise based object relational mapper. We can actually take a look onto that. So you can see this is how we are defining the schema models. You can create your own schema models, like define user, you can say posts, so it will create a collection like posts in the database. And what I'm doing here is, if you're not specifying ID, then it will create a ID as a primary key. You can say title of the post and description of the post. Let's put a type as a string. So what all types are available? So these types are actually mapped with the MySQL also. You can see char, boolean, blow up, big int, small int, array, decimal, double, float, long char, right? All these are actually mapped with MySQL data types. For now, we are fine with the string, so let's keep it. So I'm creating the posts here, post collection, okay? And what I'm doing, whenever the sync is happening, it will create this post collection with the posts table. Okay, you can create a primary key, or it will add a primary key default. You can see it has created a post stable. IDs or by default auto incremented primary key has been added. Title, description has been added. So if you just take a look onto the database, you will see the new table has been added, which is a posts. Now all the things of how I can add a primary key here, foreign key here, because this is the post table, right? We need to define the association between user and posts. So we'll take a look onto that, but for now, like if I wanted to do that, then you can say user.has one post. So what indirectly I'm trying to say, that one user will have a single post. So it's, I'm trying to put a one-to-one relationship between the tables, right? One-to-one relationship, and when you execute them, because we are right now we are forcing and creating everything again. So let's read this. What is this query? Create table if doesn't exist, and in the post I put id as a user, uuid as a foreign key. So if you just try to search it, then you can see. So let's get the description of this table. DDL, yeah. So you see, I have all these columns. What happened? Let me expand it. So here it is having a foreign key, user UUID, right? So user UUID is a primary key in the user table. Now it is acting as a foreign key in the posts table. So all those things, we will take a look into the details, how we can associate two MySQL tables, and whenever we execute them, then how the associations are getting created. For now we can see that all these different types we have in the MySQL. So in the next video, we will take a look on little bit about the Sequelize documentation, and we will try to understand what all different facilities we are getting from Sequelize.